heading back home to Sydney from Darwin, straight down the middle of Australia, 4,500 kilometres to go, passing through Alice Springs, then on to South Australia and Port Augusta before crossing to Victoria and New South Wales. Charged up at Kalgoorlie, up to 99%. It's quite an early morning, 8:21. We're going to go to Coober Pedy today, so that's about just over 400 kilometres away. So we could do it in one go, I think we could, 5%, but we probably won't. We'll stop. There's a place called Mala on the way, so we'll go to Mala. It's got a three-phase charger. We'll probably stop there, have a look around, get some brunch, I suppose. It's only going to be there at 10:13. Add another 10% into the car or so, and then get to Coober Pedy easy. So, first stop is Mala. Out in the desert at the moment, it's cold nights and beautiful, sunny, clear days. So, looking forward to this part of the journey. See Coober Pedy. Very interesting data this morning. Really low average watt-hour per kilometre, 115, the range of 562, and our projection is way lower. I don't know why that is, but very interesting. Quick charge up for an hour at Mala, or had a cup of tea and a biscuit. Cost me $10, which is pretty good. Now we just head up Coober Pedy, but we should get there with heaps 34. So this is actually going to be a day with lots of charge. I think I worked out why I was getting such good mileage. We've got a pretty strong tailwind, probably about 15 k's an hour, so that's why. Cruise to Coober Pedy, about 110, got here with about 25% and then just drove around town a bit, had lunch, and they've got a Tesla charger here as well as a three-phase outlet at the Desert Cave Hotel, which is right in the centre of town. So we'll charge up here tonight. I'm about to jump on a tour of a mine at 4 o'clock, and that'll be off. That'll be all for Coober Pedy. Bit of a tricky situation here to leave the outback today. We're at Coober Pedy. We want to get all the way to Port Augusta, which is about 540 kilometres, so we have to charge along the way. The halfway point to charge, Glendammo, the three phase is not working there, so we have to go on to a place about here called Woomera, which is about 375 k. So we've got to get from Coober Pedy to Woomera in one go, which would be okay, no problem at all. The only trouble is that we have a fairly strong, this is wind. Wind is up to nearly 30 kilometres an hour from the southwest. A bit lighter this morning, probably about 20 kilometres, getting up to 30 kilometres by 10 a.m. So that means the wind is coming in this way. So we should be okay if we can get down to there before the wind gets too strong, and then it's sort of about even across that part. So we'll get away reasonably early. We'll probably just start off at about 90 k's an hour, hypermile it a little bit because of that wind, see how far we get and make sure we can get to Woomera there, in one charge. So a little bit tricky just because of the wind. The wind was howling last night like a dust storm on Cooper Pedy.
Okay, well, it's all charged up in Cooper Pedy. We're heading off to a place called Spud's Roadhouse, which is just on the turn off to Woomera. So we can't stop here. We're going to have to stop there because that one's that three phases out of order. 367, it says we'll get there with 5%, so maybe it's taking into consideration the wind and so forth. So we are going to hypermile it for a while.
So we've been sitting at 90 most of the way and getting about 150, 155 watt hours per kilometre, which is sort of normal for 100 or 110 because of this headwind. We're now starting to drop down below 150, and I think that's because we're starting to head a bit more west. So the wind is coming up sort of this way and it's less of a headwind. So we might increase our speed to 95 and kick on a bit faster. Through to Spud's Roadhouse, pretty successful hypermiling, even though it didn't really do much. But look at this, you know, we sort of just keep our average down to 150 depending on the speed. And if we look at this, yeah, so we're just sort of adjusting our speed to make sure that we're above the grey line. I'm coming in at about 11%, should be good for a 3 hour or so charge up and then off to Port Augusta.
Got into Spud's Roadhouse near Woomera with 10%, so good timing. Let's see if we're going to go to Port Augusta. It's going to be about 200 k's, 190 k's, and I think I'll need about 60 or so percent. So a better route planner told me I need about 40% to get to Port Augusta. That doesn't count wind, of course. So I've set this to set to 60%, gives me 20% buffer, so I'll lose, say, 10% on wind and 10% spare, which means I need 3 hours and 15 minutes to charge. So about 3:30, I'll be ready to go. So, time to watch a bit of Netflix on the car, get some lunch, have a chill out. Charged up here at Spud's Roadhouse. It says almost 5 o'clock. That's because I actually stopped halfway, went off for an hour and had a look at the Woomera rocket sort of town. So now we came back, did a couple of hours while I played video games on the Tesla screen and had a few phone calls. So we're probably a bit overcharged, 23% when we get to Port Augusta, but with this headwind, who knows. So we'll set off at a cracking pace and see what we get when we get there. This is probably the last time I'll use the three-phase charger because after Port Augusta, we're back on the DC chargers. There's a supercharger at Clare, not far away from Port Augusta, and then all across Victoria and New South Wales to get back home. So long, three-phase. So long, AC. Next stop is DC.
Hi Zach and Jesse, this is Jeff, all the way from South Australia. This is the Woomera. This is the one-stall supercharger, or not really supercharger. It's just a 32 amp, three-phase, 240 volt plug. Charging up here, it's going to take us about 3 hours to add 60% to our car. So charging up here for a little while. Yeah, there's not much here. There's a desert. There's Spud's Roadhouse, which is petrol, food, and probably beer. So I'd give this a 2 out of 10 for facilities, but I'm actually going to give it 11 out of 10 because it's the only place to charge within about 200 or 300 kilometres. So charge up here, and our next stop is Port Augusta. Thanks, Zach and Jesse. Now you know.